fpKIDS, how's everyone doing? I'm so glad you're here as we continue to take a closer look at faith. See, faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see. And maybe it seems strange to trust in something that you can't see, but actually, we do it all the time. Let me just show you. Everyone, stand up. Go ahead, stand up. Okay, now on the count of three, everyone jump. One, two, three, jump. All right, have a seat. Now, let me ask you something. When you just jumped up, did anyone keep going and float through space without coming back down to the ground? No, of course not. If you said yes, it was a no. See, we can trust that gravity will keep us on the ground. But we can't see gravity, but we sure would notice if people started randomly floating up into the air. Having faith in God is kind of like that too. Maybe we can't see God with our eyes, but when we focus on the things that He's done in our lives and in the lives of other people, that can help us put our trust in Him. So to kick things off for us today, how about we play a little game? Come on.
Hey fpKIDS, my name is Sherlock.
And my name is Holmes. And we've got a great game about focusing for us to play today. It's called Lost in the Details.
Here's how we'll play. We'll put a picture up on the screen for about 15 seconds. You'll need to study it really closely to make sure that you know all the details in the image. I mean, every little tiny detail. Then we'll show a slightly different version of that same picture. You'll have 15 seconds to find the tiny little detail that's different from the version that was on the screen before. Are you ready? Let's take a look at picture number one.
All right, let's see if you spot what's different in the version. If you know it, call it out. Ready, set, go. If you notice that his tail is pointing down, you're correct.
Great job. Okay, let's move on to picture number two.
Here's picture number three.
See picture number four.
And for our very last picture, picture number five.
Great job, everyone. You sure are good at focusing on the tiniest of details. Now, let's get ready to sing and worship God together. Everyone, up on your feet.
fpKIDS, this song is called Happy Day. We are so excited to celebrate that Jesus is alive. So with one heart and one voice, let's celebrate this good news. You guys ready? Here we go.
The greatest day in history. Death is beating you, have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive.
Awesome job. Other hand, you guys ready?
An empty cross, an empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
Other way.
perfect peace. Earthly pain finally will cease. Celebrate, Jesus is alive. He's alive.
Oh, happy day.
Oh, happy day. Happy day. You wash my sin away. Oh, happy day. Happy day. I'll never be the same.
Ready, bring it down.
Great job.
Back up. And back down.
Good job, you guys.
FpKIDS, this song is called Gone. We get to proclaim that our sin is gone because of the sacrifice that Jesus made for me and that he made for you. So with one voice, we're gonna sing it all together. Are you guys ready?
I'm gonna live.
job worshiping FB Kids. We had so much fun getting to do that together. So this month we are focusing all on faith. That's right. And today's Bible story will help us learn that knowing Jesus changes the way you see others. Pretty incredible, right? Let's do it.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Acts, chapter 10.
As the early church grew, Peter traveled from town to town telling people the great news about Jesus and how He healed sick people. Now in Jaffa, He raised a dead woman back to life through the power of God's Spirit.
Tabitha, get up.
Many people in Joppa became believers, so Peter stayed there with a man named Simon, a leather worker who lived right beside the sea. Peter often went up to the roof to pray.
Ah, this is the life. Thank you, Lord, for all these fellow Jews believing in Jesus.
But God's plan was bigger than Peter imagined. About 40 miles north, a Roman army commander named Cornelius was praying too.
Lord, thank you for all you've given to me and my family.
Though Cornelius was not Jewish, him and his family worshiped God. They freely gave to anyone who needed help. While Cornelius was praying, God sent an angel in a vision.
Cornelius.
The angel's power and brilliance was so strong, Cornelius fell back in awe.
What is it, Lord?
Your prayers and gifts to poor people are like an offering to God. So He has remembered you. Now send men to Joppa. Have them bring back a man named Peter. He is staying with Simon by the sea.
Yes, Lord.
The angel vanished. Then Cornelius leapt from his feet. He called on two of his servants and a trusted soldier and told them everything.
Leave at once for Joppa.
Sir, yes, sir.
The trio left around 3 o'clock. Marching at top speed. Around noon the next day, they neared Joppa. At Simon's home, Peter had climbed up the roof to pray.
Lord, you've done amazing things here in Joppa. What's next? Lunch is next, I guess.
While lunch was being prepared, Peter continued to pray. And God sent him a vision, but it wasn't an angel.
What is happening?
It appeared to Peter that something like a large sheet was dropping from heaven. It contained a zoo of animals, pigs and camels, rabbits and birds and reptiles.
Get up, Peter. Kill and eat.
Peter stared in shock. The Jews were forbidden to eat the meats of these animals, which were called unclean.
No, Lord, I will not. I have never eaten anything that is not pure and clean.
Do not say anything is not pure that God has made clean.
Two more times, the same thing happened. Then the sheet was taken back up to heaven. Peter blinked and looked around.
What does it all mean?
At that very moment, the men sent by Cornelius arrived at Simon's front door. Is there a Peter staying here? Up on the roof, God's Spirit spoke to Peter.
Three men are looking for you. Get up and go downstairs. Don't let anything keep you from going with them. I have sent them.
Still, overwhelmed by his vision, Peter hurried down the steps, right out the front door, where he found the men.
I'm the one you're looking for. Why have you come?
Sir, we have come from Cornelius, the Roman commander. He's a good man who worships God. The angel told him to invite you to his house so Cornelius can hear what you have to say.
Go to his house?
Just as it was forbidden for Jews to eat certain foods, it was also forbidden for Jews to enter the home of non-Jews.
Oh!
In that moment, Peter understood his vision. God was making a new rule about what was clean, the story of Jesus was not just for Jewish people, but for everyone.
Please, come in. We'll leave first thing in the morning.
The next day, Peter and the three men set out, along with some of the believers from Joppa. The following day, they arrived at Caesarea.
This is the home of Commander Cornelius, sir.
Thank you.
Peter must have paused for a moment before he entered the house. Though God had told him to come, he had never entered the house of a non-Jewish person.
Here goes.
At the home, Cornelius had gathered all his relatives and friends to listen to Peter.
Greetings, Peter. We are honored you've come.
The commander lowered himself before Peter, showing a sign of deep respect.
Stand up. I am only a man myself.
As Cornelius stood, Peter surveyed the room before him. He took a deep breath.
You know that it is against our law for a Jew to enter the home of someone who isn't a Jew, but God has shown me that I should not say anyone is not pure and clean. May I ask why you sent for me?
Cornelius had explained everything the angel had told him, and Peter shared how God sent Jesus here to share God's love, how Jesus taught and healed people through God's power. Then he would be killed. But then God would raise him back to life again.
We ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people. All who believe in Jesus have their sins forgiven through his name.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Glory to God.
Before Peter could finish speaking, God sent his Holy Spirit down to be with Cornelius and his family and friends. The Jewish believers who came with Peter, they stared in amazement.
But they're not Jews.
Surely no one can keep these people from being baptized with water. They have received the Holy Spirit just as we have.
Peter baptized Cornelius and his friends and family in the name of Jesus. He stayed with them for several days, overjoyed by the new perspective God had given him.
Wow, what a great story. What a great reminder that God thinks everyone is super valuable and important. God told Peter that he should give others a chance. He wanted Peter to reach out to Cornelius and his family, even though they didn't come from the same background. But because Peter did, Cornelius and his whole household put their faith in Jesus. Wow. If you think about it, the reason that we know about Jesus today is because, well, someone told us. And God wants all people to know him. His rescue plan is for all of us. And way back at the beginning of the story, God promised Abraham that he would bless the entire world through Abraham's family. Fast forward all the way to today's story, and we see how God showed Peter that his story is for the world, just like he had promised to Abraham. So this weekend, just remember, knowing Jesus changes the way you see others. That's our bottom line. And here's the thing, God wants you and me, all of us, to love all people, even if they're different from us. Some people might talk differently than you do. They might look differently than you do. They might like different things than you do, but none of that means you can't like them. When we know Jesus, that means we should show love to everyone around us, not just the people who are most like us. And our faith in Jesus helps us focus on others. It helps us share God's love with everyone we meet. FP Kids, thank you so much for joining us this weekend. And just a reminder, we will be back live in person at all of our campuses next weekend with FP Kids. But families, if you feel more comfortable at home in this season, we will be having FP Kids Church at Home online through July. We'll see you guys next weekend. Bye, friends.